Hey everyone, I'm Pete Estes. Welcome to Catamount Weekly presented by XFINITY here at the Waterbury Ice Center, about 30 minutes south of UVM's campus. The Boston Bruins just wrapped up practice here, and a familiar face for Catamount fans joined them on the ice today. Here's more on the newest Bruin and former Catamount, Kevan Miller.
Well, I think he's improved immensely over the year in Providence, and he's become a very steady, reliable defenseman. Again, everybody knows he's not the flashy type, but he is very dependable. He's big, he's strong, he defends well, he moves the puck well, and he's got a good shot. So he's got a lot of qualities, and he's certainly a guy that's had a great camp and earned a spot with us.
It's great. I'm excited with the opportunity they've given me. I came into camp pretty optimistic and wanted to make the team, and right now it looks that way. Obviously, everyone's dream is to kind of grow up and play in the NHL, and I had aspirations of playing in the NHL, and I think it's been a little bit of a process. I've been down in Providence for 2 years, and I've been itching to get up, and finally getting a little bit of an opportunity, which is great. It's great. To be honest with you, I haven't been able to get up here as much as I would have liked to. I'm from California, so summers are a bit tough to get back to Vermont. I've been able to go up there a couple times, but we just had the trip up in Stowe, and it was great to be back and see some people actually came down, so, and hopefully see some people here today. So it's been great. You know, like, a lot of people are like, oh, you're surprised and this and that. Like, you come into camp, I have goals, like, you know, to play in the NHL, and it's I wasn't surprised. It's like it's exciting, you know. It's a good welcoming, and I think it's, my reaction was, you know, like, you know, right. You know, I'm happy about the opportunity, and hopefully get in some games.
We'll stay on the ice for the play of the week presented by the Victory Club. Brittany Zuback of the women's hockey team had herself quite a weekend, and she scored a hat trick in the Catamounts 5-1 win over the Nepean Wildcats.
Leading it forward to the front of the net, and they show up and they score. Pelke, Amanda Pelke has a player down the slot. Campbell, good shot, she scores. Brittany Zuback, her second of the night. Back to Rapaci for a drive. Saved by Bombay with the rebound. She scores! Brittany Zuback, her third of the afternoon.
It'll be a busy weekend back on campus, headlined by a celebration of the men's soccer program's 50th season. We got a sneak peek at a video time capsule about the program. Take a look.
In 75, we came down and took over Centennial Field, which in many ways started the standard where things could now happen, because it was a facility. It was one of the best in the country. An honor to go down and be part of that environment. And the players felt that way. And when the fans started showing up in that stadium field, it just sort of opened up a doorway for things to happen in the future. So I think the concept of we now have a recruiting tool, we have something that's going to make a lot of sense. And it was an honor to be on a field that was one of the best you could ever be on.
The honors continued for Reinhardt. He was named the NSCAA National Coach of the Year. The ball kept rolling for Reinhardt and the Catamounts as they earned NCAA berths in 1977, 78, and 81 to set a benchmark for success at Vermont.
Pride is just, it's standards. If you set something down where you accomplish something, it's a matter of repeating what you've done before and trying to improve on it. So it's just the concept that we were able to accomplish something that we had done before.
Reinhardt retired in 1984 and left with a program record 78 wins. His replacement, Ron McEachin, continued to build upon the legacy of success. McEachin's team in the late 80s was led by four future UVM Hall of Famers, Roberto Beal, Kevin Wiley, Jim St. Andre, and Einar Bohmer. In 1988, the team won 10 games, finishing third in the North Atlantic Conference, and Kevin Wiley became the first and only Catamount to be named Conference Player of the Year. The stage was set for what would be a historic campaign in 1989. Vermont went 19-3-1 that season, including a program record 20-game unbeaten streak.
That's all from us here today on Catamount Weekly presented by XFINITY. As always, make sure you head over to uvmathletics.com for all the latest news, videos, and more. We'll see you right here next week on Catamount TV.